reminded where we're at. I've got my game up and running, and I can move around diagonally. But currently what I want to be able to do is have him pop off screen and reappear on the left. Currently he just continues all the way across. So what I need to do is, after I have moved him, I need to do a check to see where the fox is. So I can check to see if fox.x is greater than my width, right, whatever my width of the screen is. Well, then what I want to do is I want to set my fox.x to be back on the left-hand side of the screen, which would be equal to 0. So if I run that, I'm going to go back. I was doing some other code testing for someone. That's why I changed my dimensions. This is what I want. I'm going to continue. And there he goes. So this is looking good. Now, one thing I want to do is I'm going to be exact. I want to see what happens as I get there. He's still not off screen. One more click. And there he is. So that's not bad. I might want to, so basically I think what it does is based on the center of the fox, and I think that's totally acceptable. That's going to work. So now that I can do that in the x direction, I can do the same thing for the opposite. So this, isn't, there's no way he's going to be both on the left and the right. So I can do an LF here. Fox.x is less than 0, then fox.x is equal to width. I'm using an LF because in the previous case where I wanted them, it's possible both left and right keyboards could be pressed at the same time. So I want them to check all options. In this case, from an efficiency standpoint, the fox can only be left or it can be right. He can't be in both locations at once. So there's no need for me to check each time. If one is true, then it can skip the next comparison. And I'm going to test that. So you'll see I test my code all the time. So there. So you can keep going back. And that's doing working as expected. Now up here, it is potentially possible that I could be both at a certain height. If right now, if I went both left and up, I could appear, I could be in both locations at once. So I'm going to check my y separately with a new if block. If fox.y is down left is greater than my height, then fox.y is over here. But I can't be both at the top and the bottom at the same time, so then I'm going to put an elif here, if fox.y less than 0, then fox.y will be equal to my height. So if he's top, he'll go back down above. So I'm going to test that. And that seems to be working. And I'm going to try in the diagonal portion. So that seems to be doing what I would expect. Yeah, it does get a little confusing when I open this location here. I'm not sure if that's what we want, but we'll leave it for now. I don't know exactly how, what should, I mean, apparently that's correct. I find it a little bit confusing, but I think that's correct. So now what I'm going to want to be looking at now is actually going to do this collision detection. So this update, this is where so much of our code is generated because it's constantly checking the 60 times a second. So down here, what I want to do is I'm going to do a check. So if fox.collide, so there's a built-in feature in Pygame with actors. So actors have collision detection. So there's a method called collide, and I can check to see if it collides with another object. So I think I can say if fox.collides with my coin, so I've got two actors, a fox and a coin, and I can check collision between two actors. So if fox.collide, colon, I'm just going to quickly test to see if this works. So this is my way of just, I don't want to put too much code in if this first line is not correct. So I'm going to run it now and see. So that didn't work. It does not like the collide. It has an attribute collide. All right, so back to my docs. This is, well, I don't have everything memorized. Type in collision or collide. Climb correct. Control cut. Collision, looking for COL. Collided. After all, has seen attributes and methods as rect, including methods like collide rect, which can be used to test whether two actors are collided. So I don't just say collide, I have to say collide rect. Try that. I was hoping to come up with code. So I'm looking to see collide rect. Let me try that. Collide rect. And then I did a collide rect with. And try that. Now it's in time. Oh, I need a colon at the end. Run. Oh, so no error, so that's good. Now I'm going to come up and see if I can collide. Oh, I'm getting a collision. So that's good. But I don't actually want it to print collide. What I want to do is I want the coin to disappear and reappear. So the benefit here is that, remember I've got this place coin? So what that means is I can place the coin in a new location. So instead of printing collision, what I'm going to do is I'm going to call my function called place. I call function with the brackets. And so now when a collision is detected, it's going to remove the coin and put it in a new spot. All right, so that seems to be working. So that's a really good thing. All right, so not only is it colliding, what I want to happen is I want to keep a track of the score. How many coins have I collected? So I'm going to create a variable called score. I'll set that equal to 0. And every time I collide, every time I place my coin, I'm going to print score. So my score is 0. I'm going to come up. Okay, score is still 0. But what I need to do is after I have collided, if I've collided, then I also want to increase my score. So in this case, what I need to do is I need to define my score as a global variable. If I just say score plus 1. I try running that. I get an error. The local variable score is referenced before assignment. So I start referring to score. But because this is inside of a function, the computer doesn't realize what score I'm talking about. I'm, of course, talking about this score here. But I am not allowed to change a score, a variable, global variable, a variable from the main program inside of a function, unless I explicitly state I want to do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, inside of my program, I'm going to define score as global. So when I talk about increasing my score, I'm talking about the score that is the, in the main, a main variable. So I define it as saying it's the global score that I'm going to be referencing inside of my function, and I want to now increment that value. So if I run this now, I come over, I now have a method of keeping track of my score. Okay, so at this point, I'm going to ask you to do that. And number 4. Just print score. score was 3, it should say that. So adjust that in your program so that the score will be printing down here on the bottom, and then I will later we'll take a look at how we can actually generate this on the screen itself. Get it so that it's not just printing the number, but it actually says score with the value. And then later we will look at generating a scoreboard up on the top, maybe with a time function as well.